वेलकम लर्नर्स, आई एम डॉक्टर सुहासिनी वाजपेयी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, स्कूल ऑफ एजुकेशन, महात्मा गांधी अंतर्राष्ट्रीय हिंदी विश्वविद्यालय, वर्धा. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन टॉपिक कोऑपरेटिव लर्निंग अप्रोच एंड मेथड्स इन साइंस. इन दिस सेक्शन वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड स्टेप्स ऑफ कोऑपरेटिव लर्निंग, आइडेंटिफाई की एलिमेंट्स ऑफ कोऑपरेटिव लर्निंग, एडॉप्ट द स्मॉल ग्रुप इंटरैक्टिव लर्निंग मेथड, डेवलप लेसन प्लान्स बेस्ड ऑन कोऑपरेटिव लर्निंग मेथड ऑफ टीचिंग. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद व्हाट इज कोऑपरेटिव लर्निंग. इट इज अ टीचिंग स्ट्रेटजी इन विच स्मॉल टीम्स, ईच विद स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ डिफरेंट लेवल ऑफ एबिलिटी, यूज अ वैरायटी ऑफ लर्निंग एक्टिविटीज टू इम्प्रूव देयर अंडरस्टैंडिंग of a subject. According to Roser and David Johnson, students who work cooperatively on learning tasks tend to relate more positively to their peers, to view learning as more positive, and to learn more information. In cooperative learning atmosphere, each member of a team is responsible not only for learning what is taught but also for helping teammates learn, thus creating an atmosphere of collective achievement. Through interaction, students learn to interrogate issues, share ideas, clarify differences, and construct new understandings. Students work through the assignments until all group members successfully understand and complete it. Why cooperative learning should be used in our science classrooms? In the traditional way of teaching learning, teacher passes on the information to learners, who passively listen, mechanically jot down the notes, and vomit out the received information in the examinations. In cooperative learning, learners take responsibility of their own learning. It promotes self-learning skills in them. They have to discuss their ideas with their group members, relating it to their previous experiences. In this method, teacher facilitates situations for active participation in teaching learning process. Let us discuss about what are the components for effective and inspiring learning. Actually, learning happens when only our students are engaged in five big C's. First one is student's choice. Second one is collaboration. Third one is communication. Fourth one is critical thinking. And fifth and last one is creativity. Classroom based on these five C's is required a shift. A shift from teacher-centered classroom to learner-centered classroom. This required from teacher his or herself to move from role of a sage on the stage towards a guide on a side. This opens opportunity to not only to teach but to coach, to mentor, to nurture, and to inspire our students. In the process of cooperative learning, learners are actively participating. In this process, teachers learn and learners teach. Members of the group are always respected while they are working cooperatively. Activities are interesting and challenging to make sure that students have proper interest on that very problem. In the process of cooperative learning, defined goals with provided resources are available. Learners are invested in their own education with common goal of learning. What are the rules while we are working effectively in the engaging our learner cooperative environment? We have to follow the rule once framed by us. If anyone fail to bring any change, do with the consensus of all. While working cooperatively, speak clearly and in complete sentence. During the activity, always try to listen each other's idea attentively without interruption. Be polite to others working in your group and wait for your turn to respond. Give value to each other's ideas also while working in cooperative settings. Evaluate each other's ideas and communicate it to the respective members. Member will try to improve without taking it otherwise. It is an activity or experiment to be performed in the group. Everybody will get opportunity to try his or her hands on it by turn. What are the responsibilities of a teacher in a classroom where engaging learner in cooperative learning? The role of teacher is like a facilitator. He should work on preparation, helping groups get started, monitoring group work, assessing and reflecting. Let us take one by one. What is the preparation? It is for articulate your goals for the group work, including both the academic objectives you want the students to achieve and the social skills you want them to develop. This is for determine the group conformation that will help meet your goals. This is for choosing an assessment method that will promote positive group interdependence as well as individual accountability. Second step is helping groups get started. After proper planning, when we are allowing as a teacher group to get started, explain the group's task including your goals for their academic achievement and social interactions. Explain how the task involves both positive interdependence and individual accountability and how you will be assessing each member of your group. Assign group role or give groups prompts to help them articulate effective way for interaction. In third step, monitoring of group work. Regularly observe group interactions and progress. It can be done by circulating during group work, collecting in progress documents, or both. When you observe problems, intervene to help students move forward on the task and work together effectively. Last step is assessing and reflecting after the group work. In addition to providing feedback on group and individual performance, it is also useful to provide a structure for groups to reflect on what worked well in their group and what could be improved. What are the benefits to the students while as a teacher we are using cooperative learning techniques in our classroom? In this technique, students help each other in clarifying concepts and problem solving. Confidence is built through oral presentations and written discussions. Critical thinking is developed. Appreciation of and respect for other ways of thinking. Positive attitudes about science and the science classroom are promoted. Cooperative learning approach develops both academic and social skills in learner in an integrated manner. Few examples of cooperative learning methods we as a teacher can frequently use in our classrooms while imparting science education at the secondary level. These techniques are think, pair, share, peer instruction, jigsaw technique, student teams achievement division, that is STAD, team accelerated instruction, that is TAI. Let us think about one by one. The example of think, pair, share. In this technique, we have to perform three rounds. In round one, that is think, have students think or write about a discussion question. First of all, group the student. Try to make a small group for effective cooperating learning environment, and then give opportunity for round one, that is think. After round one, proceeds towards round two, that is pair. In this step, allow students to turn to a partner and discuss their responses. Give proper time for appropriate discussion. After discussion, go for round three, that is share. In this round, start a group discussion by having each pair share their responses with the class. So, in this think, pair, share method, we are giving our students the opportunity to discuss their own opinion and thinkings with their group member also. And we have opportunity to learn from other members also. Second is peer instruction. When we are using peer instruction method, we have to go through one question that should be of conceptual based, and as a teacher, you should post this in the group of students. Question, give the question, post a conceptually based multiple choice question. For example, suppose your sister calls to say she is having twins. Which of the following is more likely? Assume she is not having identical twins. In this question, we have four options. First one is twin boys, second one is twin girls, third one is one boy, one girl, and fourth one is all are equally likely. After posting this question in the group, give opportunity to every individual to respond according to their own opinion, that is individual responses and discussion. Have students answer with a personal response devices, that is clickers you can use, then turn to a neighbor and discuss about your response. You can see in the figure that responses before discussion for option A, B, C and D are as likely. In this section, we can see that most of the student responses for option number D. Now, allow students to change their answers after discussion. When students start discussion, they are discussing about what are the possible answers and which one is correct one. So, after discussion, display responses and use as stimulus for class discussion. And as we can see that before discussion, response D was considered as the correct response, and after discussion, response C has been considered as the correct response. So, this is the method again promoting development of social skills in learners. Third technique we are commonly using in our classroom is jigsaw technique. You can see in the figure that in jigsaw technique, we are making groups of students, and these groups are responsible for interacting and attaining towards solution of any problem. Round one we are going for, it is considered on focus groups, and round two is called as task groups. For round first, divide students into groups and give each group a different text to read and discuss. As we have in this diagram, four groups, and each group has to discuss on different topic allotted to them. After giving proper time for discussion, go for round two, that is called as task group. In this, mix the groups so that students can bring their specific focus to a common task or problem. In this example, we are taking one member from each group, that is focus group, and mixing in a group by creating task group. From group 1, 2, 3 and 4, we are selecting one member and making new groups. By this method, again we are going to inculcate social skills and ability of peer interaction among our students. In this method, again, students are very interested and they learn science in inspiring way. What are the key elements of cooperative learning? First one is positive interdependence. Second one is face-to-face interaction. Third one is individual or group accountability. Fourth one is interpersonal or social skills. And last one is group processing. Let us discuss one by one. First one is positive interdependence. The spirit of this positive interdependence is we can do it together. Each group member's input is necessary for the group success. Unique compared to that of other members. Required by teacher created evaluation guidelines and used to share materials, roles, goals, rewards or resources. In positive interdependence, we are sharing materials, we are sharing roles of students, we are sharing goals and trying to work on common goals. And again, we are sharing rewards and resources also. In the cooperative learning environment, face-to-face interaction is also there. The spirit of this is, I will help you and we will finish together. Students help explain and assignment to others. In this technique, students share their own knowledge to increase the group's understanding. Students discuss the topic while they are learning cooperatively. Students connect personal experiences and prior learning with task at hand. Third one is individual or group accountability. The spirit of this is we all have to do our part. For successful cooperative learning, a small group size ensures all members' participation, include solo and group assessment. As a teacher, try to randomly selected members share group findings. Quality control officers keep groups on task. Students teach others what they have learned. Interpersonal or social skills development. The spirit of this is how can we work together to accomplish this? Cooperative learning always reinforces in our students ability of leadership, ability of decision making, ability of proper and effective communication, and ability of conflict management also. While our students are working in cooperative learning environment, they are working together and developing various interpersonal and social skills in themselves. Last one is group processing. The spirit of this is what did we learn here? In the environment of cooperative learning, it is also important that at the end of assignment, every student is capable of understanding that what he learned here. To ensure that the assignment succeeded, group members should continually assess their learning and assignment progress. Students should provide feedback about how helpful the tasks were. The class as a whole should determine which activities should be continued. What is the cooperative learning setup? If we are seeing it in our classroom, you can see in the picture that in cooperative learning setup of our classroom, students are interacting with each other in group. In this class, teacher works as facilitator. The role of teacher to facilitate learning of these individual groups individually as well as cooperatively as a whole class. Every group is concentrated on common goals to achieve after the learning. Why should we use cooperative learning in our classroom of science? Cooperative learning enhances students' learning by improving students' academic achievement, increasing students' self-confidence and motivation, increasing students' liking of school and fellow classmates, and at last, preparing students for success outside of the classroom. Let us take one by one. How cooperative learning improves students' academic achievement? When our students are get engaged in cooperative learning environment, it promotes student learning through more active participation. The cooperative learning environment always motivates students to learn the materials. It increases student retention of material they had studied. Cooperative learning results in greater student productivity. Cooperative learning increases students' self-confidence and motivation as it provides students with an opportunity to construct their own knowledge, helps students to further develop their oral communication skills, promotes students' self-esteem, social competence, and psychological health. It enhances students' satisfaction with their learning experiences. Cooperative learning increases students' liking of school and classmate. This is very important point for discussion, that when as a teacher we are using cooperative learning method in our science classroom, the tendency of students to like the school and classmate going to be increased, because it promotes positive interaction between members of different cultural and socio-economic groups. It creates more caring, supportive, and committed student relationships. It provides a shared cognitive set of information between students. It improves student attendance in classroom. Cooperative learning prepares students for success outside of the school, as objective of science education is to inspire our student for future. So cooperative learning prepares our student for their success outside the classroom also, as it promotes the importance of working together to reach goals. It provides students with the ability to communicate, cooperate, assess, and delegate. It stresses the significance of students getting along with and communicating with others. So, if we are using cooperative learning environment, so our students are ready to succeed when they are outside the classroom. Suppose if we are going to teach by cooperative learning method in our classroom, so what would be the draft of lesson plan? You can see in the picture the basic steps of lesson plan for cooperative learning method that is proposed by Johnson et al. Is like this. In this pattern, you have to make some common entries like name of a school, duration of your class, for which class, for which period you are going to teach, what is the subject area, and number of students in your classroom, number of groups you are going to create. These are the basic requirements you need before starting with cooperative learning methods in your science classroom. Then after these general entries, you need to frame about objectives, as cooperative learning method simultaneously focuses on academic and social skills both. So we have to plan our objectives accordingly. So first, plan for your academic objectives, and then plan for social skills you want to inculcate in your students. Next step is decide what cooperative strategy you are going to take. We have taken jigsaw technique for teaching our student in science classroom. Then mention about area of expertise. What will be academic task you are going to take up, and what are the criterion for success you are planning? Decide about role of positive interdependence among student. Mention clearly. and what will be responsibility of each and every student, decide it in terms of individual accountability. Then point out about what are the expected behavioral outcomes of your students you decided as teacher. For monitoring of cooperative learning, teacher would monitor and organize the whole class. Intergroup and intragroup interaction would be organized in an effective way. Behavior observed. The behavior of the students would be observed by observation schedule, a tool made by teacher. After this, in last stage of lesson plan, we have to go through assessment of learning. So, we have to write goal setting. What are the small group processing? That is the interaction and discussions among the member of the same group. What is the whole class processing? That is the interaction among the experts of every group on the same subtopic. And what is positive interdependence and individual accountability? That is element of cooperative learning in the group. In conclusion, we can say cooperative learning is a method of teaching science by which we are going to engage our students to increase their academic achievement, their self-confidence, their motivation, and inspiring them to learning by doing. The learner sitting in the classroom has different abilities in them. So, we are grouping those learners with different abilities that will help for inculcation of various interpersonal and social skills in them also. So, by this method, at the same time, we are achieving our academic goals as well as social skills development. Thank you.